So, Josh, a victory tonight. You did a four-rounder against Paul Cummings.
Yeah.
And you did a job on him. You sort of worked every round. You seemed comfortable out there. And you seemed to go at the pace that you wanted to go at. Is that right?
Yeah, yeah. Obviously, because I'm on the comeback trail, it was just a case of getting the rounds out. And more importantly, we didn't want to put it on him. And we didn't want to get him out of there because it's these times when you learn your trade sort of thing, and these are the hard lessons learned. So it was a case of we wanted to get the rounds out, we wanted to box well, use the jab and just not get drawn into a gunslinging match. And yeah, I did it.
Which... Yeah, and Paul's been around the block a bit, so he knows the score, he knows what's going on there.
Yeah.
And he's there ready to make sure you do get the rounds.
Yeah.
And he's quite a tough opponent in certain ways. You know, you've got to be sharp thinking.
Yeah, yeah. He's a tough kid, and there's nothing against Paul, but... He come to do his job, and we got the rounds out and everything worked. And any time I hit him and hurt him, I just come away again and set myself, went again, tried not to apply too much pressure and just work on the things I need to work on.
Yeah, so I'm introducing you as the Fighting Pride of Uttoxeter. Unfortunately, that pride got damaged a little bit with the defeat last time round.
Yeah,
talk us through that.
That was, I'll be honest, it was one hell of a fight. Emmanuel was super, super fit and super tough. He didn't hit me with a shot that hurt me. He's not physically strong where he hits you and you go, wow. It's just pressure. And the pressure just, because I had him wobbled a couple of times and I had him worried, I went after him. And this is where you see, this today makes so much sense because I learned from my mistake and I wanted to show people, look, I can box, I don't have to put pressure on all the time and I can win these rounds and I can tick these boxes. So that's what tonight was about. It was about ticking all the right boxes.
Yeah.
And Emmanuel, to be honest, I will have a rematch with him some point down the line. I can't let it
go. You can't let it go.
No. But he's a tough kid, and I've got to take my hat off to him. I can honestly say I was beaten by a better man on the day. I personally don't believe he'd beat me again, and that's a fighter in me.
Yeah, the thing is, I mean, I know you're away from the boxing ring as well, and I know that, you know, you speak from the heart and you're a very sensible lad, so you've got your head screwed on, and I really do believe that that's what you believe. It's not just fighting to sell tickets.
No,
it's not like, oh, get yourself down there, boys, because I'm going to knock this guy out. It's not like that.
I agree with you, and I think you're 100% right, but I think one thing I've always wanted to do throughout my pro career, and I've always wanted to show people, is that I'm a massive fan of Gennady Golovkin, and I think the way he presents himself is absolutely unbelievable, and he never ever tells people he's going to knock him out. He never does this, he never does that. He just says, be a good fight and we'll see, knowing, quietly confident, that he's going to do the job. So I always try and portray that sort of thing, that I'd never talk down to anybody. I'm not one for calling people out. I want big fights, and there's a few people I'd like to box, but I'd have the respect to speak to them first and say, look, I think we should, you know, do it. It's a business, let's do a job.
Yeah, that's good, because you don't need to light the touch paper on certain fights. The fights will make themselves, and
at the end of the day, I pride myself on, I can punch, I can box a little bit, as I show people tonight, and I wanted to get it across to people. You don't have to be arrogant to make fights. In boxing, you're either loved or you're hated. I'm neither. I just want to go about my job and just enjoy doing it. And the people from Uttoxeter, I cannot thank them enough. My sponsors, a lot of stuff gets lost. Trust me when I say this. People expect, if they actually knew how much money boxers make, they expect, it's not what people think. And it's the sponsors that put you through this. I wouldn't be able to afford to box because it's thousands of pounds a year. I have to travel 30 miles to the gym and back. Every day, five times a day, a week, sorry. They're a big part of it, and without them, I wouldn't be able to do what I do. So I've got to say thank you to everybody for that. I mean, definitely my mum and dad, because they give me everything, and my missus puts up with everything for me, and my mates and that, and I just.
And that's the side, though, Josh, that nobody sees. You see, all they hear is, I'm a professional boxer, and they think you're lording it up, driving around in the big Merc.
They do.
You know, you've got the house on the estate miles away from anywhere.
If I'm truthful, I don't earn a lot of money. I wasn't brilliant at school. I do okay for myself, and I work 60 hours a week, and then I'll come training on top of that, and I'm trying to do a house up at the minute as well. So I'm cutting myself really fine, but what I'm trying to say is, if people understood a little bit more of just how hard it is and how hard it has become to be where I am, they'd understand why I say thank you so much.
Yeah.
And they'd get the you can't explain to people how you feel for their generosity, and you can't explain to people just how much it means without sounding over the top. But God's honest truth, everybody supports you. Brilliant.
Well, you're a humble guy, and it's always a pleasure to watch you in the ring and come and see you here in Stoke.
Thank you, mate. Cheers. Thank you.